Hey squad, so I want to talk to you about the bare bone fundamentals of this platform right here. Now, when it comes to fundamentals, we must consider the most important fundamentals, which are sight alignment and trigger control. Now, the best way to practice fundamentals is with BRM, basic rifle marksmanship. Bare bone fundamentals. It's the foundation on which everything sits, and we need to have an acute understanding of those fundamentals before we start putting other stuff on top of it. So, when it comes to BRM, basic rifle marksmanship, the old-fashioned BRM lingo says that we must build a position to achieve a natural point of aim. How can we define natural point of aim? Keeping in mind that the clarity by which something is defined will determine the effectiveness of its application. I like to define natural point of aim as comfortably on target with zero muscular input. So, I've got some dummy rounds here. We're gonna load those up, and we're gonna talk basic fundamentals. So, now, the objective here is to group, right? In order to group, we have to abide by the fundamentals, especially those two most important, sight alignment and trigger control. So, build a position to achieve a natural point of aim. I wanna get as much of my body and the rifle on the ground as possible. No, there is no issue with putting your magazine on the ground. That's an anachronism. Little history behind that. In the 50s, the combat rifle was the M14. It was short-lived and taken over by the M16 in the 60s. The M14s didn't go away. They stuck around in the military, and the Army and the Marine Corps used those as for high-power matches. Hey, Gretchen. She's gonna keep me company right here while we do this. Now, in the high-power match, those guys got really good at marksmanship, and they got tasked to write the manuals, marksmanship manuals, for the Army and the Marine Corps. And the manual stated that you cannot put the magazine on the ground because those marksmanship teams couldn't put their magazine on the ground because it gives the shooter an unfair advantage. So put your magazine on the ground if you're going to group and get a zero. All right. So we want to get as much of our body and the rifle on the ground as possible. We don't want toes up here because no, your natural point of aim is going to get thrown off. You want ass behind the rifle. You can cock a leg if you want to free up your diaphragm breathing. It's up to you. High up on the pistol grip, deep into the pocket of your shoulder. Make sure your stock is extended. I'm going to pull this over. Make sure your stock is extended all the way. We want to use as much rifle as possible. Straight up and down with the cheek stockwell. Straight up and down. We want to make sure that we're looking directly to the center of the aperture. We want to make sure we're looking directly through the center of the aperture to mitigate any parallax, that bending of light through a lens. I know your maker of your optics say that your optic is parallax free, because the law of freaking physics don't apply in his shop. They all have parallax to some degree. So we got to make sure that we're looking directly through the center of the aperture. Deep in the pocket of your shoulder. Now what I like to do is this hand off initially. Excuse me. Breathe in and breathe out. Because I want to see that sight rising and falling in a straight line. Once I'm there and at my respiratory pause or apex of my exhalation, I want that dot to fall right into the center of that black target. So in and out. Once it's there, this hand comes up just for support. That's all it's there for. Safety comes off and I start my trigger control. Now, how much finger should we put on that trigger? A lot of us, way back in the day, were taught this right here. Splitting the distal phalange, because that's so much fun to say. I'm going to call that an anachronism taught through institutional inbreeding. When we have this, we have built in a fulcrum. So I'm going to suggest, whoop, get rid of that gap and build a vise instead of that fulcrum. So deep into the pocket, hand off, breathe in, breathe out, safety off, start your trigger control, sight, squeeze. Boom, the gun fires, cycles, chambers another round. We still have pressure on that trigger. Now we need to realign the sights and reset the trigger. Sight, squeeze, boom, the gun fires, cycles, chambers another round, realign the sights and reset the trigger. So that's how, the objective here is to group, right? We want to make sure we have the good group, especially if we're zeroing, because you can't zero unless you have a good group. In order to group, you have to abide by the fundamentals, especially those two most important fundamentals, sight alignment, trigger control. And we want to maintain consistency. We want to do the same thing the same way every time. 5X, 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 every time. Rock and roll, baby.
Woo!